Hey everybody, this is the LEGO City 2017 ATV Race Team set. Let me show you each of the major assemblies separately, and as I go along, I'll kind of put stuff together. First of all, the ATVs themselves are very small and simple builds. The builds are identical between them. They just use different color schemes, and there's one single sticker for each, and those just go with the color schemes. But in spite of the small size, I feel these scale pretty well to the figures. Maybe they look a little bit plain from around the back, but they look fun. They look like they would give some really good enjoyment and sportiness for the figures who will be riding on them. Now I'm going to load up one of those quads onto the back of this pickup truck. It has ramps that come down. This looks like a very nice bed. You know, it's nice and smooth. There's plenty of room to drive this up. You can actually drive it right up. Maintains traction with the ground the whole time, and when you bring up the ramps in the back, all helps to hold the thing into place. This truck itself is a very nice build. It's got a 6-wide build at the front for the cab and then an 8-wide build as you go back to the bed, so it's going for kind of an extra heavy duty kind of look. Very large, definitely oversized tires here, but I feel that all scales pretty well. And it uses a handful of stickers, not too many. I feel like the one that's used for the hood there is really important. Not so much the one on the top, on the roof, not so much these on the sides, but these on the side do add in that little bit of white to kind of continue the white stripe all the way through. This gives you access to the driving compartment. As usual, very easy to remove the roof, and just have a centered single position for a single figure to be able to sit in there. The next ATV I will roll up onto this trailer, which also has the ramp that comes down in the back, a pair of them, and the ATV is able to just roll right up there. These kind of link together, the two flaps at the back, and they will also hold the vehicle into place very nicely. This is pretty low. The wheels used are small, and it has places to hold on to a fuel canister, which you can also remove. A little clip there to hold on to an included wrench, or if you have any other tools, you can include those. And they also have a spot that actually holds on to a spare tire for the quad. This is able to be hitched up directly to the truck. It's got a small stand on it in the form of just one of these small robot hands, but it'll hitch directly up to the truck, and this is at a good level with the ball hitch there, so now everything's together. Between the two figures included, the guy on the right has nothing new in terms of parts, but the lady on the left has a brand new torso print, which I think looks very good, and they didn't go too far with the proportions on it, but I do feel like that could have been done as a gender neutral torso, so you could have used it as a male or female torso if they just left the waist marks out. Really doesn't add anything in this case. I think that could have been used for males or females. They do include two helmets, which is very important for safety, and it means that now both of these can ride ATVs at the same time. I've complained in the past about LEGO's seemingly never-ending upscaling of vehicles, but I feel like this truck is another one that gets it right, where the proportions seem appropriate relative to minifigures, relative to the quads that are in there, and also relative to the 4-wide plus a little bit size of the standard LEGO City cars that they have around. And when you put everything together like this, with the trailer and with the quads in there, it just all flows together. There's a nice harmony. It feels like this all goes together. And there's a certain amount of realism and believability here that brings some life to the scene. I feel like two of the things I dislike about this set are small nitpicks. First of all, this gap in front of the fender bugs me because it could have been at least partially filled up with a 1x1 plate behind there pretty easily. And then back at the trailer section, the spare tire holder actually doesn't hold the tire very well. It doesn't hold the wheel very well. There's just no friction in that joint, and as a result, this can fall off pretty easily during play. A slightly bigger complaint is the fact that, once again, we have a big vehicle that only fits a single figure, and yet two are included. I feel confident that the pros handily outweigh the cons on this one. I actually wasn't too excited about the set when I first saw it just boxed and in pictures online and such, but once I actually got it all assembled together and had the quads in there and saw that all as one thing together, it made sense to me and I liked it a lot. So it's your turn now to tell me and the rest of the viewers what you think about this set and what you like about it and what you dislike about it. Let your opinions be known in the comments down below, and I will talk to you again soon because my next video is on the way. Thanks for watching.